Today we're going to take this mountain and this girl and apply the double exposure effect. Hello and welcome to an Affinity Revolution tutorial. Today we'll be applying the double exposure effect. If you'd like to follow along with the same photos I'm using, I've included download links in the description. Once you've opened the image of this girl, we're going to delete the background. To do this, we need to use our flood select tool, this wand, and lower our tolerance to 10%. Then we need to uncheck contiguous and select the background by clicking on it. This has selected the background, but also some of the girl's face. To deselect this, we're going to use our quick selection brush, and while holding down Alt or Option, we can paint away the selection inside of her face. Once that is painted away, we only have the background selected, and we can press Delete to remove it, and then we can press Command D to make the marching ants go away. The next thing we're going to do is add a white background. To do this, we first need to add a new pixel layer. So press on this button, and then we're going to give it a white fill by coming up to the top to Edit, Fill. And since white is the standard background color, we're just going to press Apply, and then drag this layer to the bottom so it's underneath our girl. Next, we're going to duplicate the image of the girl. We can do this by selecting the layer and then pressing Command J, J for jump. Now we have two duplicate copies of the image of the girl. Now it's time to bring in the image of the mountain. We can do this by coming to File, Place, and then selecting the mountain image. So open that up, and then simply click anywhere on the photo. Now our mountain image has been placed into our document. We can resize it by dragging on these corner handles. We want to fill up the entire image. So drag it out until it covers the whole girl. Okay, that looks good to me. Now we're going to take the mountain layer, drag it underneath the bottom layer of the girl, and then drag it to the right. Now if we uncheck our top layer, we can see that the mountain clips off wherever the image of the girl finishes. If at any time you want to move the mountain, all you need to do is click on this triangle, make sure the mountain is selected, and then you can move it around and replace it anywhere inside your image. For now though, I'm going to hide this mountain layer by clicking on the triangle again, and then making our top layer appear again by rechecking this box. Now we're going to change the top layer's blend mode by first selecting the top layer and then changing it from normal to average. You can see that the top and bottom layer are now blending together. Now we're going to apply a mask to our top layer by clicking on the mask icon. And now that we have a mask applied, we're going to begin masking out some of the top layer so more of the mountain on the bottom will be revealed. To do this, we need to use our brush tool, which we can access by pressing B, B for brush. And by pressing the bracket keys underneath the equal sign, we can make our brush bigger. We'll also take the hardness down to 0% and the flow down to like 30-40%, somewhere in that range. Now we can begin painting away some of the top layer, which will leave more of the mountain on the bottom revealed. If at any time you feel like you've painted too much of the girl away, you can paint in white to bring her back. So just press X to switch your color to white, and then you can paint to bring back any part of her that you want to include in the image. The last thing we're going to do is give our image a little more pop. And we can do this by pressing Command L, L for levels, and then dragging our black slider to the right and our white slider to the left. Then we can exit out of this and enjoy our beautiful new photo. I hope you enjoyed learning how to use the double exposure effect. Be sure to subscribe to see more fun tutorials in the future. So hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next Affinity Revolution tutorial.